really tough outcome, and I'm curious about your perspective on what happened defensively in that.
It's frustrating. I think one of the main things is just we got a little lax. We thought we kind of went out there with the mentality, you know, if it takes them long enough to drive down the field, we'll get out of here okay. But we should have just kept putting foot in on it. That's frustrating. And I know that everybody's especially with how hard everybody was playing and trying to stay in the fight.
I guess how do you shift that mentality now?
It's a mentality we already have of hunting. We just have to continue to hunt and never, you know, take our foot off the gas. I think that sometimes we get a little comfortable and we need to stop getting comfortable.
So it's a matter of discipline?
In some cases, yes, but I think it's there. You could see it. You've seen it tonight. It's just little things. But once those little things are fixed, I think we're going to be on it.
What do you think about Will and just what he was able to do for you guys in the tough spot for him?
I mean, I'm impressed with him, really. He went out there and he put a couple of really good drives together, giving us a pretty good lead. And it's on us at the end of the day to keep that lead.
You know, TCU, Savion Williams, number 3, the big tall guy. Saw him run the Wildcat, I think, like 7 times last week. What was kind of the game plan against him? What's the difficulty with defending him?
We had a check for Wildcat, and, you know, it's, at the end of the day, it's just trusting the keys. Personally, I messed up. I didn't trust my keys on one. But it's just coming downhill with the intent to cause havoc, and I think a couple of times it was just, you know, we closed our eyes or, you know, overran it or got sealed. But I think we'll make the adjustments to do better next time.
The touchdown pass to Savion in the first half, that 75-yarder, before he came out of the backfield, you were chasing him. Were you supposed to have him out of the backfield, or is that a miscommunication where you thought they were still deep?
In that call, we haven't had reps of that particular play. And from my knowledge, I believe that I had to drop my hook, but now we know that we're going to get a danger call because he's technically an imposter, so he's a wide receiver in the backfield, so I'll be there next time.
Ben, right there at the end, I mean, we could literally see you punching, ripping, trying to get that ball out of their hands. Just talk about what the coaches were saying in those timeouts. You know, you were kind of mentioning that hunting mentality.
It was still belief that we could do it. It was just, hey, just get them down, hold them up, get the ball out, do whatever it takes, scratch, claw, fight to stay in this. And in that last drive, I believe we did that. It's a difficult situation.
Did anything from the Baylor loss come over to this team, or was it all independent coaching?
I would say they're pretty independent. The weeks of practice were completely different. There's a completely different drive this week. It's difficult, especially when people start getting injured on the field.
I guess talking about that difference, Joey mentioned that you and Jacob went up to him, kind of talked about this idea that you're trying a little too hard to be perfect, make all those perfect plays. What changed this week, maybe communication-wise with him or with yourself?
I think it's just getting a line and assigned pre-snap, and then when the ball gets snapped, shut the brain off. Just playing football like we've been doing the whole life.
Anything else for Ben? All right, we'll have Caleb Douglas here in a minute.